cottonwood bark has been exposed to a lot of wind and sand and whatnot, so a lot of people are a little bit scared of carving it for ruining their knife, but I don't really have much trouble with it. It's quite soft. Once you get the outside off, it carves very easy, and it's got a really nice grain in it. A lot of people shave off all the bark to do it, but I like to keep bark on each end so that it shows that it really is bark. And so to start with, I get in there after it and try and raise up what I call a ridge. I need a ridge up on top to start my face. And I don't clean it all off, but I get enough so that I can get a ridge in there. And then what you want to do is start building the nose. The nose, are you seeing this okay, or what should I be doing?
That's good right there.
Okay. Maybe I'll be better this way. So I start in whacking away and trying to decide where the nose is going to be. I can always take off more wood for the beard down here and for the face up above. So the first thing is the nose. The nose is the highest spot on there. So you got to kind of get him exposed in there. This will be the bottom. Kind of like so. And then I take a gouge, and we have to, I'll see if I can put a couple of the balls of the nose on there. So I'll start doing that nose by putting in some balls. And then go up to the top. But we got kind of a nose started in there. Once we get the nose in there, this one's got a nose in it, we're gonna start developing the eyes. You look at this across and you can see the nose is sticking up. That's the point that we want. From there, we'll go back into the eyes, and I take a gouge and go around and create them. When you're doing this, you have to do the left eye first. You don't have to do the left eye first, but when you're doing the other one, if you're right-handed, you have to match that. If you do this one first, when you're working over here, you can't see what you're trying to match. The first eye is easy to make. The second one takes a little more work. But we go through here. And we kind of create the eyeball back there. Light in here is not good at all. Okay, you can see where I've created kind of an eye socket. And then I go back in there again with a V tool. And when I go back in there now, I'm creating the eyelid. And I clean that out a little bit. Kind of round that out to be an eyeball. Now, some people will paint those. Another option is to just take a piece out of that and you'll create an eyeball. I'll just do it. What I'm doing is just creating a hole there. And that hole will become kind of the iris of the eye. Can you see that? This might be a little bit better. You can see the eye on that one. Or you can paint it. I don't have any along that I've painted.
That looks better.
That looks better. Okay. So anyway, we've gotten that done. Now we can move on and start on a mustache. We got a nose sticking up there nice. We've got an eyeball in there. I won't do the other one, but we start in on a mustache. And a pencil works good. Take your pencil and kind of draw what you're going to do. Gives you some idea. And again, to try and make them look the same. I've done about 100 of these. Tell you a little story. I don't give away very many wood carvings. A friend of mine that's a wood carver was at a yard sale, and there was a little picnic bench or a little park bench about 4 or 5 inches long. And there was 4 characters on there all carved out. I mean, somebody had spent probably a couple months working on it, and it was sitting on the yard sale for $4.50. You know, the guy had at least a month's work into that. So I give a few to my family, but outside of that, everything I've got I've still got. Okay, we're going to try and develop some mustache in there. And we'll do that with a gouge also. We'll just cut out that line. We'll outline it first. And in here, we'll do the bottom of the mustache. If you haven't done too much of this, you should be wearing a cut-proof glove. But I've been doing this for 30 years, and I still cut myself every so often. But I'm just going to cut away the extra now, and that will make that mustache stand out. It cuts really easy. It's really nice wood. If you're buying cottonwood or picking it up, you got to look at the end. You look at the end grain, the top is always flaked like this. And those will fall off really easy. You can glue them back on, but the less flakes that you've got in here, the better piece of wood you've got. I don't think I've got any that I've sawed off. Anyway, that's what you want to look for. I don't want to bore you too long with this, so I'm just trying to show you the basics and then we'll move on. You can see how easy that carves. It's just beautiful wood. And when you spray that with polyurethane, it just comes alive. I see it looks like I kind of fell asleep here and didn't get that under his nose where it should be. Now just to give him a little life, we'll underneath that, we'll put a little lip in there. We'll just cut a gouge out. See if I can clean that up a little bit. Now we'll just cut out a little bit underneath that. Being careful not to chip it out because it'll chip pretty easy. And when you're doing this, if it chips out, it's not a big deal. You just go a little deeper. You got lots of wood there. Can you see that lip coming up? Then we'll go in and do it a little deeper in here so that we can get a shadow to show his mouth, and that'll also make his lip come alive a little bit more. You see that very much? Not too much. Needs to be a little more under here. Okay, we've got a kind of a lip there. This one here has got the eyes in it already. But we'll take the one that we were working on and we'll start defining that mustache a little bit. And I'm just going to take a V tool and I'll follow that down. And this is going to give us the appearance of hair in there, or mustache. And this is kind of random, however you think. You kind of don't want to make any straight lines if you can. There's nothing in a mustache that's straight. And you can use a bigger tool. Put some deeper ones in. and then work on them, kind of braid them in. Boy, it's really hard to see. Okay, we'll call that good enough. We got to take out some more for a beard. And we can roll that around the edge if we want to. There, I just flaked off a bunch. I don't know if you've seen that. It's all right, I can just go deeper. And we'll start doing some beard in there. And we'll make it just fall over the edge, kind of the fall of the wood. I'm doing this kind of crude, as I'm just trying to show you. It's not something that I'm going to want to give away or anything. And we can go back and make it a little finer. I've got a couple of finished ones out on my table out there that you can look at that are a little more carefully done. But now we got a beard coming out underneath there. We can kind of call that good. We'll get up on top. Here's one with a beard. You can probably see that a little bit better. The eyes I haven't punched yet. But now we'll get up and try and do something up above. And again, you can let your imagination run wild. Some of them I've just put a coonskin type hat on. We'll try and put a little bit of hair up on this guy. We gotta have a spot to start. Kind of put a hairline up here. Oh, that was a little bit too aggressive. Okay, now we've got a spot to start doing our hair up there. We can take a V-gouge or a U-gouge And we can just create some hair going up. Kind of wild. He's kind of a wild character. We'll run some more up the other way. Kind of get the idea of what I'm doing. We can take a smaller one. It's not very good. Well, they just aren't. I can't hardly see them. I'm sure you can't. Well, anyway, that's the idea. You can be a little fussier and interweave them in that. I'm just going to clean up his forehead here a little bit. Then we'll get a small V tool and we'll put a few eyebrows up here. They show up at all? Now this is always concerning, so we want to put some bags under his eyes. We'll get a U-gouge and we'll just put some gouges under his eyes. That's going to make him age him a little bit. And he also has to have some eagle claws or whatever out on the edge of the eyes. So we some kind of wrinkles out there like he's squinting. These need a little touching up. They're kind of rough. But that's pretty much what it looks like.